Ajnanatimarandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chaksurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. Namo Vishnu Padaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine. Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Precharine Nirvisesha Shanyavadi Paschacha Dejatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So we're going through Srimad Bhagavatam, Canto 6. This is Chapter 2, how Ajamila is going to be delivered by the Vishnu Dutas. So the Vishnu Dutas are explaining to the Yama Dutas what are the actual principles of religion. So they describe how people everywhere follow a leader. There's always a leader in society, and people will follow his example and imitate him. And whatever the leader accepts, then the other people will accept that.
无论这个领袖接受什么，其他的人也会接受这个。So
Ajamila was actually to be taken by the Yamadutas, and they wanted to take him to Yamaraj for punishment. Haribo? Subhuri?
Hare Krishna, Subhuri Roy Prabhu, 我们听不到您了。对，可能是他的网络不好。Well,
I'm also here. 我也在这个地方，我没有，这里没有问题。哦，他掉线了。
Hare
Krishna, sorry, 我的这个 Wi-Fi 刚刚掉了，我现在用我的流量。OK，
好的，好的，好。Okay,
so Ajamila the Yamadutas wanted to take Ajamila to Yamaraj to be punished.
Yamaduta 非常坚持的想把
But this actually that would have been against the principles of religion.
But 事实上这是违背宗教原则的。
And the Vishnuduras were afraid that if such a thing happened, then it would be very bad for the world.
Vishnudutta 害怕如果这样的事情发生的话，对于整个世界都是不好的。
It would create the impression that nobody, that even innocent people were punished.
这会给人们造成一种印象，即便是无罪的人都会受到惩罚。
So Srila Prabhupada explains how sometimes our Krishna consciousness movement also suffer like that.
Srila Prabhupada 在这里解释到，有时候我们的 Krishna 知觉的运动也会遭受到这样的麻烦。
Although Krishna consciousness is teaching the real principles of religion, the governments don't accept.
即便 Krishna 知觉教授的是正确的宗教原则，但是政府部门他并不接受这一点。
The Kali Yuga governments cannot understand the value of the teachings of Krishna consciousness.
卡利年代的政府部门他并不欣赏 Krishna 知觉所传递的这种价值观。
But the Hare Krishna movement has actually got the right method to correct the world, to bring about an auspicious condition on the planet.
但事实上 Hare Krishna 知觉这个运动找到了一个正确的方法，为这个部能为这个社会创造一种吉祥。
And to correct people from their sinful habits.
而且能够纠正人类所犯的这纠正人们的罪恶罪恶的习惯。
Unfortunately, because it's Kali Yuga, people they don't have much knowledge about what is religion and what is irreligion.
但不幸的是，在这个卡利年代，人们并不知道什么是宗教，什么是非宗教。
And innocent people are often they're compared to an animal.An innocent animal which sleeps on the lap of its master.
这些无辜的人就好比一个很无知的或者无辜的动物，它躺在它主人的腿上在睡觉。
And the animal believes the master will protect it and take care of it.
这个动物它非常坚信它主人能够保护它。
So, the leaders of society, they sometimes take advantage of people, and innocent people are killed.Although we put faith in them, the innocent people are often killed.
但这些社会的领袖有时候就利用人们的这种无辜，或者说对他们的信任，然后造成这些无辜的人也会被受到杀害。
Innocent people, they trust the leader and they have faith in him.But they often have to sacrifice their life for these people.
这些无辜的人对这些领袖非常有信心，甚至他们牺牲自己为了这些人。
Ordinary people need to feel protection from the government.
普通大众应该受到政府的保护。
So it's very unfortunate that at the present time, the governments are not able to give much protection.
所以在当现在人们不是那么的幸运，因为当今的政府不能给予人们足够的保护。
The innocent people are put into difficulty just because of some politics.
由于某些政治，一些无辜的人就被处于困境之中。
And Prabhupada talks about his own experience that when they separated Pakistan from India.
圣帕帕德在这里讲到印度的那个时候的历史，巴基斯那个时候就关于巴基斯坦的这一段故事。
The initially the Hindu and the Muslims they lived together and they were friends with each other.
在以前，印度教徒和穆斯林曾经大家是朋友，大家能够在一起生活。
But then, because of politics, they fought with each other and they killed each other.
但是这些政治家们就开始彼此的憎恨，甚至杀了对方。
So this is Kali Yuga.
这就是卡利年代。
Just like people, they arrange a nice place, a nice shelter for the animals.And the animals move, come there, and they feel they're protected, they're given food to eat. And this way the animals, they get fat. And when they get fat, then the owners come and they kill the animals.
就像很多被精心照料的这些动物们，他们主人们给他们喂食，他们也有很自由的活动空间。当他们觉得这个主人对我非常好的时候，他们也长得非常胖的时候，长胖的时候，这个主人就来了，就把这个动物给屠宰了。
So Vaishnavas, like these Vishnu Dutas, they do not do such cruel things.
这些 Vaishnava 奉献者 Vishnu Duta, 他们不会做这样残忍的事情。
They see people doing these things, they think this is very cruel, and they don't like it.
他们看到人们这样残忍的做事情的时候并不很讨厌这种行为。
But people who arrange for this, who do all this kind of stuff, who are so cruel to these animals, they will also have to suffer.
而那些安排这些动物遭受如此残忍这种情况的人，他们在未来也会遭受惩罚。
And the same way, governments who don't give proper protection and shelter to the people, they will also suffer.
同样的，如果政府部门不能给予人们恰当的保护的话，他们也会遭受痛苦。
So in the Srimad Bhagavatam,It describes how people in the Kali Yuga are generally lazy, unlucky, misguided, and have a short life.
在圣典博迦瓦坛描述了卡利年代的人们总是属于懒惰、不幸、被误导，而且寿命比较短。
They're always disturbed by many problems. They never have peace of mind.
他们总是被各种各样的问题所骚扰，他们没有平和的心意。
So this is their situation. In this life they're suffering, and after death, then they're punished in more suffering, more hellish conditions.
在这一生，他们遭受这样的一些痛苦，然后在死后，他们会在地狱遭受更多的痛苦。
So Ajamila.He had already made up, he had already atoned for all of his sinful actions.
Ajamila 已经为他的所有的罪恶行为做了忏悔。
Actually, he atoned for not only sins in one life, but for sins performed in millions of lives.
而且他不仅为这一生的罪恶做了忏悔，他为千百生世所犯下的罪恶都做了忏悔。
He did this simply by chanting the holy name of Lord Narayana.
他只是通过唱诵主 Narayana 的圣名，忏悔了所有的这些罪恶。
He was in a very helpless condition, and the only person he could think of was Narayana.
他处在一种非常无助的状况下。而唯一他能想起的这个人是 Narayana。
So he didn't chant the holy name purely. It wasn't the pure name, but it wasn't offensive also.
他唱诵的虽然不是纯粹的圣名，但是他也唱的，他唱诵的也不是冒犯的圣名，就是毫无冒犯的唱诵。
So it's in between pure chanting and offensive chanting.
他在不纯洁的唱诵和纯和冒犯的唱诵，之间就是毫无冒犯的唱诵。
Yeah, there are three stages in chanting.
有三种，就是这个唱诵有三个阶段。
There's first of all offensive chanting.
第一个阶段是冒犯的唱诵。
We have the ten offenses. If we don't follow the ten offenses, then our chanting is offensive chanting.
我们有十个冒犯，如果我们不遵守这些规范的话，我们是属于冒犯的唱诵。
You don't get any benefit from offensive chanting.
我们不会在冒犯的唱诵中得到益处。
And on the perfect stage, there is pure chanting.With love of God.
在最完美的阶段是纯粹的唱诵，就是爱着神的唱诵。
And in between the two, you have intermediate chanting, which is like a shadow of the holy name.
在这二者之间有一个中间状态的，就是影子般的唱诵。
It's not the pure name, but it's like the shadow.He's not deliberately committing any offenses, and it's not the pure name.
它既不是纯粹的唱诵，但是呢，也不是冒犯的唱诵，它是唱诵的这个影子。
它不是故意的冒犯。
它不是故意冒犯的唱诵。
So because he chanted like that.That's why he's free of his sinful reactions, and he's ready for liberation.
因为他是处在这种层面的唱诵，所以他免于所有他的罪恶反应，获得了解脱。
So the Yamadutas, they understood the situation of Ajamil.
Yamadu 他们考虑的阿加米勒的。情况外在情况
Yeah, the external feature. So, Ajamil externally was very sinful throughout his life.
阿加米勒在他的外在这个情况下，他一生是罪恶的。
So, they thought, the Yamadutas thought he should be taken to Yamaraj and should get punishment.
因此亚玛都塔就认为这个阿加米勒应该得到惩罚，所以就把他带到了亚玛拉吉那里去。
But they didn't know that by his chanting of the holy name, he'd become free of all his sinful reactions.
但是他们不知道的是，通过唱这个阿加米勒通过唱诵了圣名，他免于了罪恶的反应。
But the Vishnu Dutas, they knew this.
但是维什努都他们知道这样的，知道他的情况。
And they told the Yamadutas because he's chanted the holy name, the four syllables na rai ya na, four syllables. So he's chanted the holy name at the time of death, so he's free of all sinful reactions.
所以维什努都塔就告诉他们，由于阿加米勒在离开身体之际。唱诵了主的圣名四个音节 na ra ya na， 所以呢，他免于了所有的罪恶反应。
So there's different evidences from the scriptures to support this.
在经典中有很多的这样的一些证明来证明这样的，证明这个观点。
One sloka says, simply by chanting the holy name of Hari.A sinful man can get free of all sinful reactions.
第一个论证据，来自经典的一句是：仅仅唱诵哈瑞圣名，哈瑞的圣名一次，一个人能抵消比他所犯下的罪恶更多的罪恶反应。
And then another statement says, If somebody chants the holy name, even though he doesn't want to chant the holy name, but if he chants the holy name, he will get rid of all his sinful reactions.
第二段证明是，假如一个人唱诵了主的圣名，即便他是无意中唱诵了主的圣名，他所有的罪恶都会立刻离开。
And they give an example. They say, just like in the jungle, when the lion roars, all the small animals will run away.
这样的情况就像在森林之中，如果一个狮子吼了一声的话，所有的小动物都逃窜了。
Because they're afraid, maybe the lion will eat them.
因为这些小动物非常害怕狮子，害怕狮子吃掉它们。
And it's also said, you could chant the holy name of the Lord in two syllables, Hari.
还有一段证明说，你可以唱诵主的一个圣名，这个圣名由两个音节组成，哈瑞。
So Hari is another name of the Lord.
Hari is 主的另外一个名字。
And if you just chant even once time, once chanting this holy name, it can give you liberation.
即便你唱诵这个圣名一次，你的解脱都有了保证。
So these are some reasons why the Vishnu Duras didn't want Ajamila to be taken to Yamaraj.
这些都是维什努都塔不想让亚马都塔把阿加米勒带到亚马拉吉那里去的一些原因。
So the Vishnu Duras, they're arguing with the Yama Duras. They're telling the Yama Duras that Ajamila is free of sinful reactions.
维什努都塔和亚马都塔他们争论了起来。维什努都塔告诉亚马都塔，这个阿加米勒已经免于了罪恶的反应。
And they tell the Yamaduras, they said, Ajamila sometimes, while he's eating, he will call for his son. And he will say, my dear Narayan, please come here.
Vishnudutta 说，有时候阿加米勒在吃饭，即便在吃饭的时候，都会说，阿加米勒，亲爱的 Narayana, 请过来吃饭吧。
So because he's calling the holy name of the Lord,Although he's calling for his son, he gets great benefit.
即便他在呼唤的是他的儿子，但是这个还是主的名字，所以他得到巨大的益处。
He gets free of all of the sinful reactions over millions of lives.
他从千百万生的罪恶反应之中解脱了出来。
So previously, Ajamila.Had to maintain his family, and he had to do a lot of sinful things.
在以前，阿加米勒从事了很多罪恶活动来维系他的家人。
So although he was doing sinful things, still he would be calling for his son. He would chant the name of his son, and he would chant the name of his son without offense.
即便他做了很多的罪恶活动，但是他仍呼唤了他的儿子这个主的圣名。他而且他在呼唤的过程中是没有冒犯的。
If Ajamila had been chanting the name of the Lord just to get rid of his sinful reactions, that would have been an offense.
如果阿加米勒他在唱诵的时候，他想的是想要抵消这些罪恶的反应的话。这样的唱诵是冒犯的唱诵。
This is the seventh offense in chanting the holy name.
这是唱诵十个冒犯之中的第七个冒犯。
Right? To commit sinful activities on the strength of chanting the holy name.
借着主的圣名去行恶。
So Ajamila did a lot of sinful things, but because he was chanting his son's name, he was getting freed of his sinful reactions.
Ajamila 从事了很多罪恶活动，因为他唱诵了他儿子的名字，他从这些罪恶的反应之中解脱出来。
Ajamila, however, he didn't know that by calling the name of his son, he would get rid of the sinful reactions.
Ajamila 甚至都不知道呼唤他儿子的名字能够从罪恶反应之中解脱。
He didn't know anything about chanting the holy name.
他甚至都不知道唱诵的任何的一些事情。
But he got the benefit of chanting the holy name.
但是他得到了唱诵圣名的益处。
And so he got rid of all of the sinful reactions for many lifetimes.
因此他从很许许多多身世之中的罪恶反应之中解脱了出来。
In the beginning of his life, he had been very pure.
在他生命的开始阶段，他是很纯洁的。
And although later in life he became very sinful, because he had been chanting the name of his son, which was the holy name of the Lord, he got free of sinful reactions.
后来他从事了很多的罪恶活动。但由于他唱诵了他儿子的名字，主的名字，他又从这些罪恶活动之中解脱了出来。
So one anybody who chants the holy name of the Lord without offense, they're always pure.
所以任何一个人，只要是他能没有冒犯的唱诵主的圣名，他都被认为是纯洁的。
Even though he was calling the name of his son, it took effect.
即便他想的是他唱诵是儿子的名字，还是有效的。
So the chanting of the holy name is the best process to get rid of sinful reactions.
所以唱诵主的名字是从所有的罪恶活动之中得到解脱出来的最好的方法。
It doesn't matter if you've been stealing gold or other valuables.
无论你是盗窃了那些黄金或者说其他好有价值东西的人
or maybe you were a drunkard
或者说你是一个醉汉喝酒的人
or maybe you had cheated your friend or your relative
或者你背叛了你的亲朋好友
or maybe you killed a brahmana
或者说你杀害了一个婆罗门 brahmana
Or maybe you engage in illicit sex with the wife of your guru.
或者你和你的灵性导师，发生了灵性导师的妻子发生了非法性生活。
So chanting the holy name is the best method to get rid of all sinful reactions.
所以唱诵主的圣名是最佳的赎罪的方法。
Maybe you're a murderer and you've murdered women.
或者说你杀害了你的父亲或者说女人
or you kill the king
或者你杀害了国王
or you kill cows
甚至你杀害了母牛
so these are all very sinful things but you can get rid of these sins by chanting the holy name
这些都是极其罪恶的活动但是如果你唱诵主的圣名都能获得赎罪
Simply by chanting the holy name it can attract the attention of the Supreme Lord
仅仅靠唱诵主威士诺的圣名一个人便能吸引主的注意力
And the Supreme Lord thinks that this man is chanting my holy name so my duty is to give him protection
至尊主那个时候就会想，由于这个人已经唱诵了我的圣名，我的职责是要保护他。
Of course, you have to be sincere. You have to be genuine. You cannot cheat in chanting the holy name.
当然，你必须得真诚，你不能欺骗性的唱诵主的圣名。
So Ajamila, he didn't know anything about this, but he got the benefit, the holy name acting.
阿加米勒并不知道所有的这些，但是他得到了益处。
So, sinful men do not become, they cannot become purified by any other way as they could. The best way for sinful men to become purified is by chanting the holy name.
一个罪恶的人不能通过其他的方法得到净化，最好的净化方式就是唱颂主的圣名。
Yeah, they may try to do Vedic rituals or do some austerity, but the best way to get purified is by chanting the holy name.
一个罪恶的人或许他会从事苦行或者伟大的仪式，但是最好的方式是唱颂主的圣名。
So you, we may, if you do some atonement, some ritual atonement to get free of sinful reactions, that can help to get free of sinful reactions, but it doesn't give devotional service.
或许他通过仪式和忏悔能够使他免于一些罪恶反应，但是并不能唤起他的奉爱服务。
It's only by devotional service that we can develop the attraction for hearing about the Lord and His pastimes and His qualities.
只有通过奉献服务才能唤起让我们想去聆听主的名字、品质、逍遥时光。
Sinful reactions can be on different levels. They can be, you know, they can be severe, they can be more severe, it can be most severe. So three different levels of sinful actions.
罪恶反应可以有不同的层面，有严重的、非常严重的和最为严重的。
And there are 20 different types of religious scriptures which are to guide us in these different atonements.
有20种宗教的经典，他们可以指导我们去做这些忏悔的方式。
So it's pointed out that you may get free from the reactions of sinful activities by following the scriptures.
一个人或许可以通过遵守这些经典的原则免于罪恶反应。
But this cannot help us to become a lover of God.
但是这并不能将一个罪人提升到爱主的层面上。
But if you chant the holy name even just once, then this can immediately free us from all the sinful reactions.
但即便我们唱诵圣名一次，都能将我们免除最深重的罪恶反应。
And it can bring us to the stage of developing love of God.
不仅如此，还能将我们提升到爱神的层面上。
So, service to Krishna means to remember His form and His qualities and His pastimes.
服务神意味着我们要去记忆他的品质、形象以及逍遥时光。
And we can do this simply by chanting the Lord's holy name.
我们可以仅仅通过唱诵来达到这些活动。
The Lord is omnipotent, is not different from His name.
主和他的圣名没有区别。
So something may be very difficult to get by Vedic rituals, but you can get it very easily through chanting the holy name.
有一些事情或许通过伟大仪式很难以实现，但是我们可以通过唱诵很轻而易举地实现。
So Lord Chaitanya's program is that everybody should just chant and dance. And in this way, you get the greatest benefit.
所以主 Chaitanya 的活动和运动是唱诵和跳舞，每一个人都可以从中得到益处。
The Sankirtan movement is to give everyone the opportunity to get free of sinful reactions and to come to the spiritual platform.
Sankirtan 运动就是齐颂圣名的运动的作用，就是 能够让每一个人有机会清除罪恶反应以及提升到灵性层面上。
But if you just do religious, if you just do ritualistic ceremonies, that will not clean the heart so much as chanting the holy name.
但是如果我们只是做伟大的仪式的话，那并相比于唱诵圣名来说，并不是那么的有效。
Right, we may do some religious ritual, and then again.We want to again go back to do more material activities.
因为如果我们做一些伟大的忏悔的仪式，虽然我们在那个时候忏悔了，但是之后我们又会再去想要从事这些罪恶活动。
So anybody who wants to get free from this material, from his material karma, the chanting of Hare Krishna is the most recommended.
任何想要从业报之中解脱出来的人，唱诵 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗是最被推荐的方法。
It completely removes all the sins from the heart.
它能够清除，完全清除一个人内心的罪恶。
Just like Srimad Bhagavatam says, Srinvatam Swakada Krishna Punya Shravana Kirtana.Ridhyantastohi abhadrani vidunoti suritsatam. Lord Sri Krishna, who is the super soul within the heart of every living entity, cleanses the desire for material enjoyment from the heart of the devotee who relishes his message.
人格守身 Sri Krishna 是每个人心中的超灵，是真诚奉献者的恩人。清除品尝他讯息的奉献者内心的物质享乐的欲望，恰当聆听和唱诵这些讯息时，本身也是很好的品行。
So it's the special mercy of Krishna that when he sees that somebody is glorifying his name, or his form, or his qualities, then Krishna takes care of that person and cleans their heart for them.
这是主 Krishna 特殊的仁慈，一旦他看到某个人唱诵荣耀他的名字、形体和品质时，主会亲自的清除那个人内心的污垢。
So by doing that chanting, we become purified, and we also get the benefit of doing pious activities.
我们通过这样做，我们不仅能够内心得到净化，还能得到。做虔诚活动的结果。
We say punya shravana kirtana. Punya means pious activities, and hearing chanting is a pious activity.
Punya 就是虔诚活动，聆听和唱诵也是虔诚活动。
Even if we don't understand the meaning of Krishna's names, or if we don't understand Krishna's pastimes or anything.But simply by taking part in hearing and chanting, we get purified, we get the benefit.
即便我们并不能理解主的名字、品质、逍遥时光的这些含义，但是仅仅通过聆听和唱诵，我们都能得到益处。
The real purpose of life is to purify our existence and get out of this material world.
我们人生的人生的目标是为了净化我们自己的生存，获得解脱。
If we still have a material body, we can understand we're not pure.
只要我们还有物质躯体，我们就应该理解我们并不纯洁。
And because we have a material body, we can never have a really blissful life.
只要还有这个物质不纯洁的这个躯体，我们无法真正的过上喜悦的生活。
So Srimad Bhagavatam says we have to do some austerity to purify ourselves.
因此，圣典薄伽瓦坛建议我们应该做一些苦行，为了净化我们的生存。
It's in the fifth canto in the teachings of Lord Rishabhdev.
这是在圣典摩迦瓦南的第五篇，来自于主 Rishabhadeva 的教导。
Lord Rishabhadeva was preaching to his 100 sons.
主 Rishabhadeva 对他100个儿子教导。
And he's telling them that don't worry about sense gratification. That is there even for the pigs which eat stool.
不要担心你的感官享乐，即便在猪的身体里面也会有感官享乐。
If you just want that pleasure like the pigs which eat stool, then that is animal life. That is not human life.
你如果想要那些吃屎的猪，他们也有的这种感官享乐的话，这是动物的生活。
We have to purify ourselves. And we get that purification by tapasya, by doing austerity.
我们得净化我们的生存，我们通过苦行来净化我们的生存。
And the tapasya in the Kali Yuga is chanting the holy name and glorifying the Lord and his pastimes and qualities.
在卡利年代的苦行是唱诵和荣耀主的名字、形体和逍遥时光。
Of course, we also have to follow the four principles.
当然，我们也得严格地遵循四项基本原则。
Every civilized person, they will strictly follow the four principles.
任何文明的人都会遵循四项原则。
No meat, no fish, no egg, no intoxication, no gambling, no illicit sex.
不吃鱼肉蛋，不过非法性生活，不吸食麻醉品，不赌博。
So, by doing that austerity, we get purification, and then with that purification, we can experience real pleasure.
通过这样的苦行，我们获得净化；通过净化，我们得到真正的快乐。
So only bhakti yoga, through chanting the holy name, can do this, can actually clean the heart.
只有奉爱瑜伽可以做这个，可以真正的清除我们的内心。
Karma, jnana, yoga, they're not going to clean the heart.
业报、思辨、瑜伽都无法真正的净化内心。
So at the time of death, Ajamila loudly chanted the holy name of the Lord Narayana.
在死亡之际，阿伽米勒大声地唱诵主纳尔扬那的圣名。
So that chanting freed him from the reactions of all sins.
所以这样的呼唤把他从一切罪恶活动反应之中解脱出来。
So we're telling, so the Vishnudurus are telling the Yamadurus, do not try to take him to Yamaraj for punishment.
所以维什努都塔就对亚玛都塔说，不要再试图把他带到你的主人那里去了。
So the Vishnu Duras, they're giving instruction to the Yamaduras. They're superior to the Yamaduras.
维什努都塔就对亚玛都塔下达了命令，因为维什努都塔比亚玛都塔更为的权威。
The Yamaduras, they didn't know Ajamila was free of all of his sinful reactions.
Yamaduta 并不知道阿伽米勒已经从罪恶活动之中解脱出来。
Ajamila chanted his son's name. His son was named Narayan, and he called for his son.
Ajamila 唱的只是他儿子的名字，他儿子的叫 Narayan， 但是他在呼唤的是他的儿子。
But the holy name is so powerful that he got the benefit of chanting the Lord's name.
但是主的圣名是如此有力量，他从中得到了唱诵圣名的好处。
In the Shastra it says, Ante Narayana Smriti, at the time of death we should remember Lord Narayana.
在经典之中说，我们在死亡之际应该铭记着主Narayana。
So, Ajamila had chanted the name Narayana at the time of death.
而阿加米勒在死的时候，他就唱诵了主达拉亚那的圣名。
So he was freed of all of his sins.
因此，他从所有的罪恶之中解脱了出来。
Bhagavad Gita also says supports this. Lord Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita, he also says that you have to be free of all sinful reactions.
主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中也支持了这一点。你应该免于所有的罪恶反应。
And you should have acted piously in previous lives and in this life.
应该在前世和今生虔诚的行为。
So your sinful reactions are all destroyed.
所以你的罪恶都被摧毁。
And you should be free from the duality of delusion.
应该免于这种双重性的影响。
Then you can do devotional service with great determination.
这样你才能够坚定不移地为我做奉爱服务。
If we're not free from our sinful reactions, we won't be able to really come to the level of devotional service.
如果我们不能免于罪恶活动的话，我们其实达不到做奉爱服务的层面。
In the Bhagavad Gita, also in the 8th chapter, Lord Krishna also describes, if one can remember Krishna or Narayana at the time of death, then you will certainly can go back home, back to Godhead.
In 薄伽梵歌还有一个论据，就是说，在死亡之际，如果一个人能记着 Krishna, Narayana, 他肯定有资格回归受生。
Antakale chamameva smaranmukva kalevaram ya prayati samadbhavam yati nasyatra samshayaha. Alright, Lord Krishna is describing, whoever remembers me at the time of death, then they will come to me without fail.
主 Krishna 说，在死亡之际，如果一个人能记得我，他一定能到达我这里，不要没有任何担害怕。
So if we want to remember Krishna or Narayana at the time of death, we have to hear and we have to chant his holy name.
如果我们想在那一刻记起主 Krishna 或 Narayana, 我们得聆听他的名字。
So anybody who chants the holy name of the Lord, they get free of their sinful reactions.
任何一个唱诵主的名字的人，他能够从罪恶反应之中解脱。
It doesn't matter that they're chanting somebody else. They don't mean the Lord. We're just talking about calling somebody's name. Doesn't matter.
不管他是漫不经心的唱诵，还是在呼唤着，就是想着别的事情在唱诵，这都没有关系。
And you may be jokingly chanting.
甚至玩笑般的唱诵。
Just like some people, when they see devotees, they'll say, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Like that, they like to sing the Hare Krishna, they see the devotees. So it's very powerful, very beneficial for them.
就像有人见到这个奉献者之后，他们唱 Hare Krishna, 他们即便他们是这样的一个唱诵，对于他们来说都是有力量的，有帮助的。
Or they may be chanting for some, just for musical entertainment.
或者他们唱诵是为了音乐的这种娱乐。
They get great benefit. They destroy sinful reactions.
他们也得到益处，他们会免除罪恶。
Or they may be chanting neglectfully, without proper care. They just somehow they're chanting, they don't think, not thinking about it.
或者他们漫不经心的唱诵，并没有想着是在唱诵。
But they get rid of all the sinful reactions.
他们也从罪恶反应之中解脱。
And if somebody chants the holy name and then dies in an accident, somehow he's in an accident and he dies, then he may fall from the top of a house or something and slips and and break all his bones. So if something like that, he gets rid of all of his sinful reactions.
如果一个人在这种突然的意外之死的时候，比如说从屋顶掉了下来，或者说由于交通事故什么摔断了骨头等等这样的一些事故之中，在那样的很危险的状况中唱诵。
He doesn't have to see hell. He never goes to hell. Even if he's sinful,
这样的
even if he's sinful, he won't go to hell.
这样的情况下，他如果唱诵的话，他不会去到地狱。即便他这一生因很罪恶，他应该去地狱。但如果他唱诵，他不会去地狱。
Even if he may slip on the road and breaks all his bones,
或者他在他摔断了骨头，被蛇咬。
Or he may be bit by the snake. He may be having a lot of pain, high of fever.
或者他被蛇咬，他遭受着高烧的痛苦的煎熬。
Or he gets injured by a weapon.
或者被武器击。受就是损伤。
But he never goes to hell. He won't go to hell.
他不会去到地狱。
Because he chants the holy name.
因为他唱诵了主的圣名。
Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Yam yam vapismaram bhavam chajate ante kalevaram.Tam tam evaiti konteya sadatat bhava bhavitaha. Whatever state of being one remembers when he quits his body, that state he will get in the next life.
人在离开躯体时，无论想到什么境界，他必能到达那个境界。
So if we're chanting the Hare Krishna mantra in this life, the next life also we'll get the chance to chant Hare Krishna.
如果我们在这一生唱诵主的圣名，在下一生也会有机会唱诵主的圣名。
If we have an accident, we should immediately think of Krishna and chant the holy name.
如果我们发生遇到这种意外，我们应该立即的想起 Krishna， 唱诵他的圣名。
And even if we die, we won't go to hell. We won't have a hellish life. We cannot see hell. Rather, we may go back to Godhead.
在那个情况下，如果唱诵者生命，我们既不会去到地狱，也甚至有可能回归守身。
So if we've done a lot of very sinful things.Then we have to do more atonement, more austerity to get rid of the sinful reactions.
如果我们做了很多的这些罪恶活动的话，我们应该从事更多的忏悔和苦行。
But if you chant Hare Krishna mantra, it takes all the sins away, whether they're big sins or small sins. They're all removed by chanting Hare Krishna.
然而，如果我们唱诵 Hare Krishna 曼陀罗的话，我们无论是做了罪恶的这个程度有多么重，或者是有多么轻，一切的罪恶反应都会免除消除。
So, Acharya Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, he gives an example.
我们的先辈灵性导师 Acharya Vishwanath Chakravarti。
He tells about how Samba got rescued when he got captured by the Kauravas.
He 讲述了 Samba 被 Kaurava 就是逮到的时候免于了一个情况。
Samba had fallen in love with the daughter of Duryodhan, and he wanted to have her for a wife.
Samba 喜欢上了 Duryodhan 的女儿，他想。娶他的女儿为妻子。
So to get in, because he is Kshatriya, to get the Kshatriya's daughter, he has to show a lot of courage, has to be very brave and a good fighter.
为了娶一个查出亚的女儿，一个根据这个习俗，一个人应该显示出这种武士的精神。
So Samba stole the girl, and he went, he ran, he got away with her, but he got caught by the Kauravas, and they arrested him.
所以桑巴就绑架了他女儿。这个时候，他不仅没有成功，而且还被 Kaurava 给逮了起来。
So Samba got put in the prison.
所以桑巴就被关到了监狱。
So then Lord Balaram came to rescue him.
所以主 Balaram 就开始解救他。
And so Lord Balaram had to argue with Duryodhana to get Samba released.
主 Balaram 和 Duryodhana 进行了一番争论，希望能够救出这个桑巴。
So that when Balaram was telling them to release Samba, they didn't like it, and they didn't want to do it.
当 Balaram 提议希望放了这个 Samba 的时候，他们并不喜欢，并不想要这么做。
So then Balarama took his plow, and he began to drag Hastinapur. He was going to drag it into the Yamuna.
这个时候 ，Balaram 就展示了他的力量。他甚至想把哈斯提纳普尔弄到仰慕那里去。
Yeah, all the ground began to shake, just like it was a big earthquake.
整个哈斯提纳普尔都在颤抖，就像发生了地震一样。
So then, Duryodhana understood that he better do what Balaram says.
杜尤旦这个时候就明白了，他觉得 他现在理解了，应该按照巴拉拉姆所说的去做。
So he had to agree to let Samba marry his daughter. Duryodhana had to agree that Samba marry his daughter.
这个时候杜尤旦才同意桑巴可以娶他的女儿。
So the point is, you have to take shelter of Lord Krishna and Lord Balaram, because they will protect the devotee.
这个事情的要点是我们应该托庇于主 Krishna 或 Balaram， 他们是保护奉献者。
It doesn't matter about your own sinful reactions. The sinful reactions can be removed by chanting the holy name of Lord Hari.
不要去担心你的罪恶报应，这一切都会在唱诵圣名的过程中被移除。
And you can chant.The name of Lord Balaram, or the name of Narayan, any of these names.
你可以唱诵主 Balaram 或 Narayan 任何主的名字。
So this is the power of the holy name.
这是主的名字的力量。
Okay, we will stop here today.
好，我们今天讲到这里。
Any questions?
This question from 静心瑜伽，顶拜 Guru 以及所有的奉献者，请问 Guru， 在以前的国王几乎都是 Krishna 虔诚的奉献者，为什么到了这个年代的国家领导人却几乎没有人能成为奉献者？如果一个国家领导人是主的奉献者，那么传播 Krishna 知觉运动不就变得很容易吗？是什么让主 Krishna 改变的这样的安排，亦或是其他的原因？A basis to Guru and devotees, I want to ask, in the previously and all the kings, almost like Krishna's pious devotees, why in this Kali Yuga, every country, the leaders, they seem no one are devotees. Why is that?
Well, first of all, even in the times of Lord Krishna, not all the kings were pious and devotees of Krishna.
第一个，在以前，即便是不是所有的这些国王都是虔诚的，或者都是虔诚的，或是 Krishna 奉献者。
The Pandavas were pious. They were devotees.
Pandava 他们是虔诚的，他们是奉献者。
But not all the kings. We see there's so many kings, they came and they fought against the Pandavas, they fought against Krishna.
我们看到这个情，看到当时那个战争，就是很多人来了，他们都是反对潘多瓦，他们反对 Krishna。
There were kings like Jarasandha, and Jarasandha had many supporters. Jarasandha was always trying to kill Krishna.
我们看到有 Jarasandha, Jarasandha 还有很多的支持者。Jarasandha 他们当时也想杀 Krishna.
Kamsa, he was another demon against Krishna, trying to kill Krishna.
还有 Kamsa, 他也是一个恶魔，他也想杀 Krishna.
And so there were not many pious kings who supported Krishna.
所以也就是说，不是有那么多虔诚的国王，他们支持 Krishna. Then, she asked, if a country's leader is Lord devotees, so then, preach the Krishna consciousness, then become easy.So why let Lord Krishna change his mind and arrangement?
Well, you have to preach, you can preach to the leaders and try to make them devotees.
你可以向这些领导去传教，让他们成为奉献者。
Maybe you can do this on behalf of Krishna.
或者你可以为了 Krishna 去做这个事情。
It's not very easy thing to do.
这不是一个简单的事情。
Most of the leaders of the countries, they're not very pious and they're not very spiritual.
很多国家的领导人他们不虔诚，也没有灵性。
Yes.What was she asking again about the leaders?
Her question is, she think the leaders are not devotees is arranged by the Krishna. Why Krishna arrange this?
Krishna gives everyone independence. Krishna cannot force everyone to be a devotee.
Krishna 给予每一个人自由。自由和独立 ，Krishna 不会强迫每一个人去成为他的奉献者。
This is the material world, so in the material world you have a lot of demons.
这是一个物质世界，在物质世界是有很多的恶魔的。
You can't expect to find a lot of devotees here. If you go to the spiritual world, everyone's a devotee.
你不可能在这个物质世界找到很多的奉献者。你如果去到灵性世界的话，到处都是奉献者。
And there's much more souls in the spiritual world than here in the material world.
而且在灵性世界的灵魂是要比在物质世界要多的许多的。
Uh-huh.
Yes. Next question.
Huh?
Next question from Bhaktin Yu He Hong, Shenyang.圣典博迦瓦坛5.151的要旨说，主 Krishna 的化身佛陀采用特定的方式传播奉爱宗哲学，佛陀几乎是专门给无神论者传教，而无神论者不要神，所以佛祖就没说有神。如果他的追随者按照他的教的方式去做，就会得意，因此他是用哄骗的方式在传教，尽管他自己就是神的一个化身，但却说不存在神。我的问题是，佛陀的追随者会得到什么样的利益？In the Srimad Bhagavatam 5 canto 15 and the verse number 1 in the purport.The Lord Krishna is about Lord Buddha. Common a lot. Her question is, why the follower, what's the followers of the Lord Buddha, what they will get?
Well,
what's the benefit they will get if they follow the Lord Buddha?
Generally, the followers of Lord Buddha, they all have the desire to become Buddha.
通常情况下来说，佛陀的追随者，他们的愿望是都想成为佛陀。
If they have the desire to be the servant of Buddha, then they can go to the spiritual world.
如果他们想成为主佛陀的仆人的话，他们可以回到灵性世界。
But we don't find many Buddhas who want to be the servant. All the Buddhas, they all want to become Buddha. Their goal is to become Buddha.
但是我们并没有发现很多的佛陀的追随者，他们想成为仆人，他们都想成为佛。
So, what will they get? They will go to the junction between the material and spiritual world, and there's a river there.
他们会得到什么呢？他们会去到在灵性世界和物质世界的中间的一个地带，那里有一条河。
So they will take a bath there and come back to the material world.
他们在那里沐浴，然后又回到这个物质世界。
They cannot go to the spiritual world because these Buddhists, they don't believe in the spiritual world.
他们不会去到灵性世界，因为他们不相信有灵性世界。
They only believe in Buddha. They're usually all atheists.
通常他们是无神论者。
They don't want to be the servant of anybody.
他们不想成为任何人的仆人。
下一个问题。
Yeah. 下一个问题，来自于 iPhone， 顶拜咕噜，感谢翻译，所有荣耀归帕帕 ，Hare Krishna。Yes.
Good day.就刚才比喻红的那个问题，我想再问一下，就是他的意思就是说，因为佛陀用了哄骗的方式在给这些追随者传教嘛，所以用了这些欺骗的方式传教之后，这些追随者也没有得到什么样的益处嘛，是吧？
他用欺骗的方式传教，追随者没有得到益处。您
就刚才咕噜说他也没有得到就是还是会再回来嘛，就是没有什么好的这个利益，是这个意思吗？
对。Because Buddhism is atheistic philosophy.
因为佛教是这种无神论的哲学。
They reject the Vedas, and they don't believe in the soul, they don't believe in God.
他们不相信有灵魂，也不相信有神。
Well, there are some Buddhist masters who believe in the soul, but they say the soul it can be annihilated. They have a material understanding of the soul.
我听到有，就是有一些这些佛教的大师，他们会说有灵魂，但是他们说这个灵魂会被杀，它是一种物质的方式的理解。
So you have to understand Buddhism was an emergency situation.And Lord Buddha came because of the emergency to stop the animal killing.
We must understand that Lord Buddha came to this world to save animals. It is a very urgent incarnation of Buddha.
So it's not an eternal philosophy.
It is not an eternal philosophy. It is not an eternal philosophy.
So people who are following this philosophy, they're not doing any harm to anybody, but they're not doing any good either.
人们追随这个哲学，他们不会做对社会有害的事情，但是他们的益处也没有。
But if they start to chant the holy name, if they can chant the holy name of Krishna, then they can get some purification.
如果他们唱诵主的圣名，唱诵 Krishna 的圣名的话，他们会得到益处。
But They should not offend the holy name. They should not commit offense against the holy name.
但是他们不应该冒犯主圣名，他们不应该冒犯圣名。
So,
Sati Mataji, I think, okay.
那么就是这些佛陀的追随者在追随佛陀的这个过程当中，他不也是追随了主吗？因为他也是主的化身呢。
Yes. Yes, they're following him. Then he's an incarnation. They're following him. Yes, if they follow him, but if they're trying to become him, then it's a problem.
他们如果追随是好的，但是如果追随的又想去成为这个主佛陀的话，这个是问题。
If they just follow his instructions, they just follow him. That's good.But if they want to try to become the Buddha, then it's no good.
如果他们追随主佛陀，追随他的教导，那是好的。如果追随，但是想成为主佛陀，想成为佛的话，这个是不好。
好的，谢谢 Good day.
Next question. 顶拜翻译和组织者，所有人，当家人或朋友在奉献者的安排下做了奉献服务，而他们自己也许并没有奉爱之心，请问这样的奉献服务主 Krishna 会接受吗？他们会得到所有的利益吗？ Bindu Madhava Obeisance to Guru. When the family members and friend they somehow do somedevotional service by the arrangement by the devotees, but they don't have any devotional heart. So I want to ask, when they do this kind of devotional service, the Lord Krishna will accept, and will they get some benefit, all the benefit?
Yes, they get some benefit.
是的
，They'll get.
他们会得到一些益处。
Because they're doing, even though they don't have devotional heart, but because they're doing this service for Krishna, gradually they will develop devotional heart.
即便他们没有奉爱之心，但是他们通过做奉献服务，可以提升、发展出他们的奉爱之心。
So you have to encourage them to do more service.
所以你应该鼓励他们做更多的奉爱服务。
This is, it's very good. Engage them in Krishna's service.
这是非常好的，去让他们从事对 Krishna 奉爱服务。
Even though they don't have any feeling for Krishna, they don't care about Krishna, but you get them to do something, it's very nice.Very powerful.
即便他们对 Krishna 没有什么了解，但是你让他们能够做一些奉献服务，这是非常好的。
You can be greatly benefited.
这是最好的，他们可以得到最好的。
This is how everybody became devotee practically. We didn't have much heart for Krishna in the beginning.
这事实上也是每一个人如何成为奉献者的，因为在开始的时候我们都没有奉爱之心。
But you do a little service, you offer service to Krishna. Yes, very good.
但是你做了一些奉献服务，你做了一点点的奉献服务，这就是很好。
It will take away their sinful reactions.
这会带走他们的罪恶反应。
And it will make it easier for them to develop the devotional heart.
这也会让他们逐渐地发展出奉爱之心。Bindu Madhava also, first he asked whether the Lord Krishna will accept this kind of service.
Yes.
是的 ,Krishna 也会接受这样的奉献服务。
Of course, it's not the best service, but Lord Krishna can accept.
虽然这不是最好的奉献服务，但是主 Krishna 也会接受。
Because they're doing it, because they have some feeling for the devotee.
The Lord Krishna have some feeling or the mem or the friend.
The friends have they have a nice relationship with devotees, right?
Yes.
So、
因为这些人他们和这个奉献者有很好的关系。
So by serving the devotees, that opens the doors to liberation.
通过服务奉献者打开了解脱之门。
They don't have a feeling for Krishna, but they have a heart for the devotees.
他们对 Krishna 没有什么这个这种心，但是他们有对奉献者的这种爱心。
Because they're your family, they're your friends, and they have some attachment to you, and that's why they want to do something.
因为你是他们的朋友，你是他们的家人，所以他们想为你做一点什么。
So, because they do it for you, Krishna is pleased.
因为他们为你在做，所以 Krishna 会喜悦。Then he asked, 所以我就想要说服他们，相信 Krishna 太难了，不如让他们直接做些奉献服务，比如让他们参加 Kirtan 或协助 Kirtan， 对吗？So I think it's very difficult for me to prevent them to trust the Krishna. So just let them to do some devotional service directly. For example, like Kirtan, is that right?
Yes, very good.
是的，非常好。
Kirtan is very good for people.
Kirtan 是最好对于人们来说。
Kirtan and Prasadam, these two things, very important.
Kirtan, Prasadam, 真是非常重要的。
Help to bring them to Krishna consciousness.
能够帮助他们来到 Krishna 知觉。Okay.Not question now.
No more questions?
Yeah, I didn't find them.
Okay. So we'll stop here. Okay.
Sati Mataji.
好的，对，我们没有问题了，今天。
Okay. So, Woman Ganshi Subhuti Rai Prabhu Ki Woman Jintai De Fan E Ganshi Sati Juju Ganshi Soyo De Fung Shenzi Ling Ti.Jufu Niman, Chang Song Kwai La, Wan Shi Ru Yi, Chuan Zhao Sun Li, Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai.
Jai.